The FBI has now managed to hack into the San Bernardino terrorist iPhone without the help of Apple. And that move, of course, raising a number of questions about national security and personal privacy. The Department of Justice saying an outside group, its words, helped the FBI hack into the killer's phone. It has now dropped its lawsuit against Apple. To discuss it all, Nick Thompson, editor of TheNewYorker.com, joins us now. Nick, as we mentioned again, the FBI hacks into this phone with the help of an outside group, an unidentified outside
group. Right, so not the NSA is what they're signaling there.
Right, so what does this mean?
Well, it means a whole bunch of things. Yeah. One, it means the saga is finally over, at least this particular saga. The larger debate about encryption and privacy in Congress and tech companies, that will continue. There will be many more fights. Ideally, there will be some legislation. It also means that the government gets access to this phone, and they can figure out, you know, contactless. They can figure out the movements of the shooter before the actual incident. They can perhaps figure out some mysteries. And then what it doesn't quite figure out is what the relationship will be between Apple and the FBI from here out. And there are a whole bunch of unanswered questions, including whether the FBI will have to reveal what it did.
Yeah, you mentioned the saga. So this chapter ends. I feel the page, however, turning now. What does the government owe Apple?
Well, it's funny, you know, the tables have completely turned, right? So initially it started, it's the FBI saying, hey, Apple, help us get into the phone. Now it's Apple saying, hey, FBI, tell us, how do you get into that phone? So what the FBI may owe Apple is they may owe Apple an explanation of what the security vulnerabilities are. What did they find that allowed them to get in? They may not. The law is a little unclear. It depends on whether they got in through software, whether they got in through hardware, how exactly they did it. But it's entirely possible that the FBI will be legally compelled, basically, to tell Apple what they did.
You're speaking about a little-known process. It's called an equities review. You mentioned the difference between hardware and software. However, it would seem if the FBI is compelled to show Apple how it did it, Apple would then go about closing that security gap, thus making law enforcement's perhaps future job that much harder. It's a future job that Richard Burr, the Senate Intelligence Chairman, has all but said, we're going down this road again. So this seems, as much as it may be finished, to have just begun.
Yes. So a couple of things on that. Number one, I think we shouldn't really worry too much about this particular hack and whether the FBI has to reveal this particular hack and the stakes of it. Whatever the hack was, it applies to an iPhone 5 running iOS 7, which is an obsolete phone running an obsolete operating system. So whatever the FBI did, it isn't really that important whether they tell Apple or not. As to whether Apple will actually be responding to it, I can guarantee you Apple has hired 1,000 encryption experts over the last year, or last month. They've probably hired the best people in the world. They are absolutely going to be working day and night to make their phones ever more uncrackable. So where we go from here is there's going to be an intense fight, and ideally our Congress is competent and, you know, cogent enough to be able to go back and forth and come up with some sensible legislation explaining what the relationship should be between law enforcement and tech companies.
Aside from a hiring spree of sorts, what other impacts are there? Again, for a company that claimed to have put in your pocket and the pockets of millions and millions of others an unhackable phone, what now for Apple in terms of the business?
It's a very interesting question, and it ties into the question of whether Apple took the strong stand they took for business reasons. I've always thought that a lot of this had to do with the Jennifer Lawrence hack, right? So there was this hack about, I guess it was the summer of 2014, where all these celebrities who were using their iPhones had their personal pictures exposed. That was really embarrassing to Apple. It made Apple sort of feel bad as a company, and it took a lot of the shine off Apple. So you can see why Apple, after that, you know, and for other reasons, including the Edward Snowden stuff, really pushed encryption hard. And they pushed it hard for ethical reasons, but they pushed it hard for business reasons. They want to be a phone that you feel, they want you to feel completely comfortable putting all of your information onto that phone, and they want that phone to, you feel really attached to that phone. So there are a lot of business implications. Now that the FBI has hacked in, the question is, at the end of this case, right, let me put it this way, at the end of this case, does Apple look better because they stood up and they showed how hard it is to break into a phone? Or do they look worse because everybody leaves with the perception, wait a second, you actually can't get into these things?
Something you mentioned, something Edward Snowden, if you followed him at least on Twitter yesterday.
Man is good on Twitter.
Well, he was a Metacritic yesterday as well, suggesting, and again, we don't know exactly how they did it, but he did suggest, and he did suggest in other discussions on social media yesterday, that there was a way that everybody knew, something of an open secret. There was another way into the phone.
Yeah, this is another debate, and it's something that a lot of people are talking about. It's something Daryl Issa mentioned on the show this morning, which is there were a lot of experts who said, there is a way onto this phone, just use it. The FBI, meanwhile, saying, no, 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 we need Apple's help. We need Apple to do this for us. So What I don't know is I don't know when the FBI became aware that whatever technique they used yesterday was a viable technique. It's possible it just happened. It's possible they knew about it all along and they only said, oh, wait, we have this technique, when they realized they were losing in the court of public opinion.
So the court of public opinion being all important, yep, to a degree here. And you mentioned the optics, especially for Apple. What next now? Again, you mentioned the hiring spree of encryption experts. Yep. Are there that many new lawyers on the Apple tab now, not just pursuing whether or not to force the FBI to tell them things, but also, you know, is Apple also sitting back looking, you know, how hard do we push here before we look weak in doing so?
This is another super interesting question. So Apple has hired tons of encryption people. They've hired tons of lawyers. They've probably hired tons more PR people. Yeah. Part of what interested me about this case is it's the first time I've ever seen the government fight a company where the government is the clear underdog, right? Like, Apple has many more lawyers. They have many more PR operatives. They're much better at spinning the press. Apple completely had the upper hand once this got into a fight. So now to your question, what Apple does now is they probably lawyer up. They probably hire a ton of lobbyists in the expectation that this is going to be going through Capitol Hill. And they, you know, keep paying all their encryption experts lots and lots of money. And they work really hard to try to figure out who's working on the government side and what do they know.
So a lot of new hires here as we pick through a story that maybe
if you are an encryption expert, send your resume.
Dust off the CV.
To Tim Cook at Apple.com.
Nick Thompson, TheNewYorker.com. We always appreciate the time.
Pleasure to be here.